Hey, what's up guys, it's Tech Confusion, and today I'm going to be walking you through the process of creating a motion graphic template in After Effects for use inside of Premiere Pro. Now, motion graphic templates, otherwise known as mogrts, are super helpful because to edit them, you don't need to open up After Effects. You can do everything right inside of Premiere Pro. Let's jump right in. All right, so you'll want to open up the After Effects project you want to create a mogrt from. In my case, it's this lower third here. So the idea of creating one of these templates is so that I'm able to use this lower third in Premiere and change all of the info on it and yet not open After Effects to edit it. As you can see here, this lower third has this top text for the name of a person or the title of your project, and then it has this second line underneath for a subtitle. If you're interested in learning how to create this lower third, I have a video that teaches you how to do just that. A link will be in the video description below. Anyways, to get started making the mogrt, we'll need to open up the Essential Graphics window. To do this, just go up to Window and find Essential Graphics and open it. It will open this panel right here where you can begin assembling your mogrt. This top box here will let you name your template. I'll just name it Lower Third. Now this dropdown underneath is where you can select your master composition. In my case, it's the lower third composition. This will default to whatever composition you have open. Now the idea here is to add every value you'll want to change later. So if you want to be able to change the color of this bar animation, you want to add that value to the template. We'll do that in just a moment. Now you can add values by dragging them from your timeline panel to this open space here in the Essential Graphics window. So if I just open up my title composition here and just drag this text layer up to the window, you'll see that nothing happens because the text layer itself is not an actual value, it's a layer. However, if I twirl down this property dropdown and expand the text and drag the source text value to the Essential Graphics window, you'll see that it now lets me change the text of my lower third up here in the template window. Now to the left of this where it says source text, I can change this title to make this template more user-friendly so the user knows exactly what value they're changing. I'll just change this to main title. When you add text values to a template, there's a super helpful feature that will let you choose whether or not you want the text to be customizable or if you just want to leave the style the same and just change what the text says. I typically like to check enable custom font selection and enable font size adjustment. That way, once we're editing our template in Premiere, we can still change the font and sizing to match whatever we're making. Okay, let's go to our subtitle composition and add the source text just like we did for the main title. Then I'll just retitle this section over here. And because we already allowed the size and font selection properties for our main title, it will automatically by default enable that for subtitle as well. All that's left now is to add the color of the bar animation and the width. Let's open up our bar animation composition. Then let's drop down our second shape layer until we get to the color properties for this layer. Now just drag the fill adjustment up to the Essential Graphics panel. Now if I go and change the color up here, you'll see that the lower third updates. I'm just going to name this control bar color to keep things organized. Speaking of organization, you can add these groups in if you have too many values to keep track of. So for example, I could add a group here and call it text control and drop my main title and subtitle controls under that. And then I can make another one called bar control and drop this color adjustment under that as well. Groups are kind of like a folder that keep things organized. So let's say we have a really long subtitle where the words go off the bar, and I'll just type something here that goes off the edge. So to fix this, we can add a width slider to allow us to control the width of this lower bar so that it goes all the way beneath the text. With our bar animation composition selected, just right-click in the Effect Controls panel and add an expression control called Slider Control. What this will do is add an effect that just has a slider that currently doesn't do anything, but we can use an expression to link it to a value. So since we want the slider to control the scaled width of the bar, let's just open up to the scale property of our bar animation. Here you'll want to just press this chain icon, which unlinks the X and Y scale parameter. With them now unlinked, hold down Option or Alt on your keyboard and then press this stopwatch icon next to scale. This will let you input an expression. Just copy and paste this expression that I have in the description and paste it in this expression box here. What this code is telling the software to do is to assign the slider effect directly to just the X value under scale. Now if we wanted this slider to control both the X and Y scale properties, we wouldn't need to do a custom expression, you could just pick whip the scale to the slider. However, since we're just wanting to scale the width, we'll need to use this expression. Once this expression is added, let's just drag this slider value from our timeline panel over to our template. You'll see here that it gets added. I'll rename this to bar width and drag this into the bar control group. Next, click Edit Range, and here you'll want to set the range according to what you need. For example, I can say I only want the bar to be able to scale up to 250% of its current size, and only go down to 50% instead of 0. Now that this is set, when I use the slider, you can see that it goes down to 50, and then maxes out at 250. So as you can see, with this bar width control, I can now lengthen the bar to the perfect width to fit my text. Alright, so I think that's all of the parameters we want to add to our template. Of course, if you have more parameters, you can always keep going and add as many as you want. But now that we're finished, let's just hit this Export Motion Graphics Template button. If you haven't already saved your project, it'll prompt you to do that now. Now it'll open up this window where you can change some export settings. I'll choose a local drive destination, and just click on Browse to place it in the folder I want. If you didn't name your template earlier, you can do so here as well. I'll just save it in this folder. Then, under compatibility, it's asking whether or not you want to be warned if certain conditions aren't met. Since I have enabled the user to change the font, I'll just uncheck this first warning box about fonts. But I would like to know if someone will need to install After Effects to use this template. So once you get those set, just hit OK. It'll export to that folder you chose, and now let's open up Premiere Pro. Okay, so once you're in Premiere, go up to Window and select Essential Graphics. This will open up a window to the right in Premiere with a whole bunch of default templates. It's time to add ours now. Click on this little icon in the bottom right to add your own template file. Then just select the mogrt file that you exported earlier. Then you'll just want to find the template in this list. I'm just going to search for lower third. Just drag the template into your Premiere Pro timeline and wait for it to load. Now when I click on the template in my timeline, you'll see that all the parameters we set up in After Effects now show up on the right in the Essential Graphics window. Just change everything to your desired look and you're done. Now you can just use this template for every project without needing to open up After Effects and deal with crazy long dynamic link render times. Anyways guys, that's all for this video. If you found it helpful, please remember to leave a like and don't forget to comment, subscribe, and hit that bell icon so you don't miss more videos like this. I hope you have a great rest of your day, and until next time guys, peace out.